Tonight, 20 criminal masterminds caught in the act. From a one-man crime spree...
Move out of my way, man!
...to organized gang activity. We've got daring heists planned to the last detail.
If you push the door to get in, wouldn't you pull the door to get out?
And brazen bandits throwing caution to the wind.
Throwing the money, throwing the money, throwing the money.
Join us for a shocking look into the dark recesses of the criminal psyche.
Oh, yeah.
Who gets off on, like, looking under someone's skirt?
Featuring analysis from our cast of profilers.
I guess you would call that barking and entering.
True TV presents the world's dumbest criminals. And it starts now. After a break-in, a Florida woman installs a security camera to monitor her home from her office computer and soon sees something other than her dogs entering through the doggy door.
911. Yeah, hi. I'm watching my home on live, and there's a black man in my house, and he's robbing it. Going up, two people in the house. He's looking around. He has a white shirt. He's picked up something in his hand. Yeah, he has something in his hand.
What are you doing snacking while you're robbing? The balls on these guys. The guy grabs a bag of cheese out of the fridge. That's just not cool. You know, it's a robbery. It's not a sleepover.
He's walking next to my stereo. He's looking at my son's video games.
Go. You're robbing a house. Move it, move it, move it.
He's just walking around and going in places and looking through things.
I swear to God, it looked like they were getting decorating tips, and that was it.
Yeah, man. Why don't you check out the tile in the bathroom? That's crazy, man.
Oh, my God. This is crazy. They've got things in their hands.
Ma'am, it's okay. Officers are surrounding your house. They're not going to get away with anything.
And then there's that beautiful moment of...
The cops are outside. Bruh.
Oh, shoot.
What?
What's up, the cops, Sue?
Oh, shoot. What's up? How they know we're here?
Oh, I don't know, dude. We gotta go.
Hide, dude. Hide.
No, you gotta run. Just go hide out the window, man.
At that point, when the cops have surrounded you, get down on all fours. Just pretend you're a pet.
All right, we got it. All right, careful, careful.
Authorities charge the men with burglary and attempted grand theft.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Okay, the officers already apprehended two people.
Apprehended two, okay.
Yes.
I wonder what you'd find if you had cameras in people's houses on this show.
Maggie, stop. I told you I'm not in the mood right now.
Eat your heart out, Judy Gold.
In North Charleston, South Carolina, someone has been keying Councilman Bob King's car in the municipal parking lot.
Someone has scratched my car. I want stakeout, round-the-clock surveillance, find out who's perpetrating this crime. I want undercover, bugs, satellite photos, all that!
Police set up a video camera to catch the culprit and discover two things. One, Councilman Bob King has been parking in Ombudsman James Bell's spot. And two, this makes the Ombudsman very unhappy.
I see no one around here, let's see. Yeah, just walking by, man, just passing by. Whoops, hey, oh yeah.
Wow, what a surprise. The Ombudsman is the one actually committing the crime.
Whoops, hey, oh yeah.
That was nonchalant.
Last time you parked in my spot.
I'm on the Ombudsman dude's side, because it is clearly the Ombudsman's parking spot, and when you're an Ombudsman, that's really all you've got. Don't F with that.
Whoops. Hey, oh, yeah.
Does everyone know what an Ombudsman is? Anyone?
Ombudsman? Ombudsman?
I think the Ombudsman is like, isn't it like a, he's like a liaison between...
It's, something official.
Ombudsman.
An ombudsman is a government official appointed to receive and investigate complaints brought against government officials.
Ombudsman Bell insists he didn't scratch the car, He claims he was merely looking at the license plate to see who parked in his spot.
Whoops. Hey, oh, yeah.
He eventually pays for the damages to King's car, and the matter is dropped.
Do you know that Daniel Baldwin keyed my car once? Oh, yeah, right out here in the parking lot.
A truck backs up to a convenience store in Marion County, Florida.
Is that someone trying to take the ATM out of a convenience store? I mean, where did this come from?
I got it. Stay in the truck. I'll bring it out.
You think they're organized? Back up the truck, boom, smash the window, grab the ATM, we'll be out of there.
It'll be all right. It's heavier than I thought. Let's go.
Good rule number one, always make sure you can carry what you're stealing. Just a simple but very good rule.
You got it?
I love how the one guy suddenly thinks that it's the plug that's the problem.
There we go. All right. Shoot!
Oh, yeah. It's not this million-pound machine. If I unplug it, smooth sailing.
One, two, ha! God!
Oh! Yep, I got a hernia. That plan's off.
All right, let's go.
Oh, all that work and then you quit leaving the machine there? You guys are boring.
Note to all criminals. Once a show, someone tries to lift an ATM and put it in their van and doesn't succeed. Please keep doing it.
Coming up, fugitive drug dealers stimulate the economy.
My name is downtown all over 805, south of 8.
I'm rich!
And fashion advice for young thugs.
I can't see nothing, but woo!
Eye holes are crucial. Gotta get the eye holes. Because it helps you to see how you're ruining your life with crime.
When the world's dumbest criminals continues. St. Petersburg, Florida. A homeowner's security camera captures an apparent robbery.
Whoa, what?
Unable to pry open the door with a crowbar, the burglars opt to use a much bigger tool.
Hold up, move this stuff out. Look out. I got this, man. Stand back, man. Oh, shoot, man. Oh, damn, man. Oh, no.
Damn it, it always works in the movies.
Oh. If a door is enough of a security system to thwart your burglary attempt, it's probably time to change careers.
Get a better chance of jumping through the lock. Skinny bastard.
Get right through this door, man. Hold up. Here we go.
249! 249, set!
Damn, that hurt.
My shoulder, dude.
The duo triggers the home's alarm system and take off. Police track down one of the robbers, but the brains of the operation remains at large. San Diego, California. Police pursue known drug dealers as they flee a transaction gone bad.
Number one lane, north on 5, path in the 15.
Hoping to lose the tail, the dealers create a diversion using some evidence.
Northbound 805, path in the 8.
Hey, 14, I'm planning to be dumped out all over 805, south of 8.
Throwing the money.
Suspect throwing out money off of Murray Ridge, 805 northbound, and you have pedestrians on the freeway getting money.
I'm rich!
Sir, you got people all over the freeway here at Murray Ridge. I'm trying to get the money.
This is the best day of my life. I can get a new Corolla.
Money's being dumped out all over 805, south of 8.
I'm not getting out on the highway. I'm sorry. Again, I'm not rich.
but I'm not gonna stick my face in traffic.
Ow! Is that a car?
They're putting their hands up.
The pair is arrested and charged with multiple drug offenses. As for the cash tossed out during the chase, the DEA hopes the public will turn it over to the proper authorities.
Years ago, I would be like, shame on those people for taking it. They should return that money. Nah, f*** it. Take the money. Pull over. This world is going to hell in a handbasket. Stop and get jobs.
See, the one day I don't leave the house covered in honey is the day it starts raining money.
Back in the room.
In England, two masked thugs burst into a corner shop.
Get in the back room there. It's a robbery, all right?
But before they can see the robbery through, their inexperience gets the better of them.
Oi, Billy, I can't see nothing. And we're late for school.
Oh, there's a couple of bright futures right there, huh?
Billy, I can't see nothing. Can you?
Eye holes are crucial. Gotta get the eye holes. Because it helps you to see how you're ruining your life with crime.
I can't see nothing, but woo!
This is why every robbery should have at least one dress rehearsal.
All right, give me all your money!
Are we done now? Have we robbed the place?
Come on!
There's a camera, can see my face from way up there. I'm putting a mask back on, Johnny!
We're leaving.
You can tell they're not exactly hardened criminals when their whole plan gets foiled by some woman being like, hey!
We're leaving.
Like, that's all it took for them to be like, yeah, I'm sorry.
Well, that's what's wrong with kids today. If you can't get it right, you shouldn't be doing it in the first place.
The teens escape with a pack of cigarettes, but are quickly arrested when local police review the tape.
Come me when the robbery's through. I like Harry Potter movies.
At an Atlanta train station, a college student heads home for the summer. As he buys a ticket, a helpful stranger offers assistance.
Yo, let me help you out there, man.
I'm fine, I don't need any help.
And then...
I'm experienced in this, let me help you out.
Hey!
Tries to steal his wallet.
My wallet, man.
Yo, man, give what my you wallet. Doing? Yo, man, get off me.
Give it to me.
He's not a victim. He's a fighter. Yeah!
Give me my wallet. Give me my wallet, sir.
Choke it out.
All right, go to sleep. That's it. Go to sleep.
I can't sue no more, so I'm sorry, man.
Then he chokes the mother out. Out cold. Just put him to sleep.
That's it. Go to sleep. Go to sleep.
Yo, man. What you doing, my friend, man?
Suddenly, the mugger's partner in crime appears and picks up some of the stolen cash.
I've got nothing against Atlanta, but I just want to point out two out of the three people in this video are criminals.
It's my money. It's my money. Back off.
No money.
Back off, man. Back off or I'll hurt you.
You're crazy,
back off,
man.
Why didn't he fight the second guy? We've seen you've got it in you, so maybe he's showing restraint. All right, I've choked out the first. Now I must center myself before I kill.
Coming home. I'm coming home.
The student recovers $10 and buys his train ticket.
Yo, man, what happened? That son of a bitch choked me out, man. Yo, you a terrible mugger, too.
That kid, he has my respect. I salute him for kicking those guys' asses.
Next time I'm taking a taxi.
Coming up in aisle two.
This neighborhood used to be great before all the deer moved in.
Then in aisle three.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Who gets off on, like, looking under someone's skirt? Unless you're, like, you know, 7 years old.
When the world's dumbest criminals continues. A man roams the aisles of an Arizona department store. He stops in the makeup section, picking up a small pocket mirror. And then continues to browse.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Thanks again.
Who gets off on, like, looking under someone's skirt? Unless you're, like, you know, 7 years old.
Precious.
Something about how fast he does it is what makes it so creepy.
He didn't even bring his own mirror. Like, he just thought of it when he got there. Okay, I got this, and I've got ladies' panties I want to see. Let me combine the two into a creepy activity.
Hello. Hello again.
Oh, mother. I swear to God, if I ever saw a guy doing something like that, break his nose.
Get out of here.
This seems like the sort of crime that could be kind of traumatic for the criminal sometime. Oh my God, what is that?
Don't look at me.
I mean, can he really get mad at him? This is the closest he's gonna get to seeing a vagina ever.
The man escapes, but local police promise to put their best undercover agent on the case.
Oh yeah.
Gotcha, pervert.
A Florida couple spots a strange man inside their neighbor's apartment. They immediately phone the police and grab their video camera.
Hey, sir, how many suspects did you see?
I didn't see anybody else. That was the only guy I saw, so. But I'm sure there's probably someone else around.
When your neighbor is so keyed in on your house that they know that you are being robbed, someone tells me that camera's on your house all the time.
Yeah, dude, I was just, you know, hanging out with my camera pointed at your bedroom window, and all of a sudden, stuff started being weird.
Oh, my God. He was just looking out the window, and it's opened. I saw his face.
Wow, the remake of Rear Window is not what I expected.
What's he doing over there?
That's not his house.
I have a very bad feeling about this.
Oh, very bad.
Look at him. Look at him. He's gonna jump. He's gonna jump. He's too big to jump. His legs are gonna break.
When the police are coming, you have to make quick decisions. Do I go to jail or do I break my leg? Jail, break my leg. Break my leg.
He's going over the back fence. You're gonna see him in the middle of the street if they go now.
No. He's running.
He's running into the apartment complex, to my apartment complex.
Oh, my God. He's running towards the back of the building.
The intruder is arrested and charged with breaking and entering.
Honestly, the guy doesn't steal anything. He doesn't have a weapon. He's not in disguise. It just seems like he's a fat dude who got lost.
Apartment complex. God.
I'm calling
right
now. Hi, there's somebody stuck on a pool outside my house and he can't get down and I don't have a ladder to get him down.
Do you know who it is?
No, I have no idea.
Within minutes, police arrive on the scene and find a man in a harness dangling from a telephone pole.
What the hell's going on?
Still
copper.
Still copper.
What were you doing up there, Michael?
I'm just trying out the new spikes. Testing your boots out. You know that happens to me a lot.
What? Like, you don't practice your spike boots at night? Come on, that's like prime spike boot time.
Michael, don't worry. You know what you're doing.
No, I'm not stealing copper. I'm testing out my new boots. My new spike boots.
I'm probably gonna need the electric company up here to shut the power down.
Did they put up the slow sign before or after he wound up hanging from the pole?
Heads up. Watch the wire.
He was up there to do something. We don't even have to get a judge and a jury. Leave him up there for a couple days. That's what I would have done.
Come down the ladder.
Police run Michael's name and discover he has two outstanding warrants. He's arrested and driven to the station.
If I take you out to the hospital right now and drug test you, what are you going to test positive for?
I'm kind of wild out this week. Probably weed.
What else?
I took a drink from my buddy's drink.
Are you a meth user?
I used to be, but I'm not anymore.
Oh, and I have a couple overdue library books. A couple parking tickets I haven't paid in a while. And I'm just gonna say, look in my backyard, you won't not find bodies.
It's minutes before closing time at a Pennsylvania liquor mart. An employee rings up the last customer.
All right, thanks, folks. Come again.
All right, let's go home, eat some ice cream, and watch Operation Repo.
deer.
This neighborhood used to be great before all the deer moved in.
They're fine on their own. When they get into a group, they maraud. And that's a classic case of marauding deer.
All right, Donner, you grab the porn and beer. Rudolph, you get some smokes.
Yes. Hoof, let's do this.
All right, let's go. Let's go, guys.
Get the one in the office. Boom, she closed the door.
Where to now?
The loading dock.
Yo, girl, what's up?
Oh, shoot!
The deer eventually find their way out via the loading dock. Police are urging local hunters to help in the apprehension of these dangerous fugitives.
Did you see any deer just come through here? Huh?
Coming up, quality customer service at a Florida pizzeria.
Stop, Joey, no!
We take our calzone making very seriously.
Plus, the butterfingered bank robber.
Damn it. What's the backpack for? If you're not going to put the money in the backpack, why bring it?
When the world's dumbest criminals continues. Dinner time in Palm Coast, Florida.
Boomba's Pizzeria? Really?
What's up, fellas?
Yeah, sweetheart, you boss around.
Two customers asked to speak to the manager about their calzone.
Yo, what's up? How can I help you?
Yo, pizza boy.
Hey, oh.
Your calzone.
What the you talking about? My calzone?
Calzone. It tastes like.
The men demand their money back, unaware that the manager has a gun.
What's up? This calzone tastes like. What are you gonna do about it?
Gosh, he'll pull out a gun if you don't like his pizza. I wonder what he'd do if you were really mad at him.
Calzone tastes like. What are you gonna do?
No, Joey, no! Not the face! You're gonna get in trouble! Joey!
I'm an Italian, so I can say this. We take our calzone making very seriously.
You move!
We're running a special. People get a free pistol whipping with every order.
A wrongly made calzone. Are you kidding? Couldn't we have handled this peacefully?
During the struggle, the gun disappears under a booth. The patrons call the cops, who arrest the manager, Joseph Milano. But they soon discover he's a former mob hitman in the witness protection program. And Joseph Milano's real name is Joey Calco.
I think the witness protection program needs to start working with a new creative team. They changed this guy's name from Joey to Joseph.
And what should he do? Something completely where no Italian Americans will find him.
He could run a pizza shop.
Bing!
Great idea.
Joey is charged with aggravated assault and aggravated battery with a deadly weapon. And Goombaz is now under new management.
And just to think this could happen at an establishment like Goombaz Pizzeria, it's shocking.
Hey, welcome to Stereotype Reinforcement Pizza, where we're all irritable with links to the organized crime.
You got a problem with my calzone, you piece of.
At a bank in London, a robber makes a dramatic entrance.
On. Damn it. There we are. Hello, everyone. This is a robbery. Ah, yes, lots of money. Yes, okay, all your money. Thank you very much. Later. Bye. Ah, cold. Blimey. Ben. Damn it. All over.
Is this yours, my friend?
Here we are. See me. Thank you very much. Later. Bye.
There are so many things wrong with this robbery. I don't know where to start.
Door. Come on, man. Come on, love.
This guy even had trouble getting in the door at first. I'd say that doesn't bode well for the much more complicated actual bank robbery.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you. Bye now. Hello. Goodbye.
Put a freaking mask on, you idiot. Are you kidding? He's just like... I'm robbing the bank. Robbing the bank.
Oh, God.
What's the backpack for? If you're not going to put the money in the backpack, why bring it?
No problem. I got it. I know what I'm doing.
Is this yours, my friend?
Excuse me. Could you grab that there? Stop it. Yeah, that pound there.
Wait a second. Does that innocent bystander now become an accomplice?
No problem. I got it.
Is this yours, my friend?
Hey, listen. You never seen me.
Okay. Well, my pleasure.
It's just like the opposite of a citizen's arrest. It's just like a citizen's assist.
The bank robber is quickly identified and arrested.
There's some tips for a successful robbery. You have to be nervous, no disguises, drop lots of things, and it will go perfectly.
We stay in London, where our number 7 piece begins as a man strolls into a bank.
Good day.
Thanks.
There you are.
He hands the teller a piece of paper.
Read it.
But it's no ordinary deposit slip.
What's this then, sir?
It says, give me all your money. Cool, blimey. Cheerio.
That was the wrong bank to mess with. Hey, I'm here to rob them.
That looks serious.
Give me all your money, let's go. So long, bye-bye. No, I'm locked in. God. Oh.
If you push the door to get in, wouldn't you pull the door to get out?
But I can't believe it. I'm stuck. Pull.
Push? Pull.
Oh, God. Oh.
Push? Pull.
Oh, me mates will never let me live this down. Oh.
Just when he's ready to give up and wait for police to arrive...
Hello, are you still open?
Oh, thank you very much.
My goodness, son, what's all the hurry then? Take your time.
And then luckiest guy in the world, that old lady comes in, lets him out.
What in the name of Shakespeare? Hello.
Excuse me, dear, watch where you're going.
There is a God.
Hello, is anyone here? I've come for the free toaster. Oh, bother.
The man's luck finally runs out when police arrest him and hold open the door to a jail cell.
Why, oh why, didn't this guy team up with the elderly lady who comes in? He could handle the bank robbing, and she could handle the doors. He needs a partner. He can't do it all.
Hi, I'm Todd Bridges, and I want to tell you about a great new product. It's called Capture Air. Part ventilator, part anti-thief system, Capture Air is a must-have amenity for any restaurant and kitchen. Simply install it over the range and watch it how it sucks out unpleasant fumes while also keeping unwanted thieves from getting in.
Wait! Did you say unwanted thieves?
That's right. Capture Air will trap any crook that tries to break into your establishment via the ventilation system. Just ask this Denver pizzeria owner and satisfied Capture Air customer.
I heard a scream. I can't breathe. And then I looked up and I saw this leg.
Help! Help! Come on, I've been here all night! Come on! Help me!
So when I come in the morning to open my pizzeria, there's gonna be a guy already caught in the vent? Can I pay by credit card?
You sure can, Matt. In fact, you'll be willing to pay in solid gold once you hear about all of Capture Air's great features, like how it inflicts maximum pain upon would-be intruders.
The hole he went through was, what, about 16 by 16? When he hit a couple of the obstructions that were in it, the steel rod sticking out like that and almost penetrated his abdomen area.
Well, I don't understand who puts things in a ductwork to impale people in the first place.
The engineers at Capture Air, Tonya, that's who. But wait, there's more. Capture Air makes sure that when the criminal is removed from the system, he's degraded emotionally as well as physically.
Yo, man, why you gotta cut my pants? That's all I got.
You had to strip him naked? Did you really have to?
Yes, we did, Brad. Because that's the Capture Air guarantee.
How are you feeling this morning?
Get me away from crazy Capture Air, for real.
Before Capture Air, my life was scary. But now with Capture Air, I can cook and catch a crook at the same time.
Oh, God.
Capture Air. Order yours today.
It'll be the best decision of your entire life. I should know. I'm on TV.
Coming up.
You know that big picture of a cigarette with the X through it that's right on the gas pump? It's there for a reason.
Christmas Eve in Murray, Utah. At a local supermarket, customers do some last-minute holiday shopping. But little do they know, a thief lurks in their midst. The intruder carefully scans the aisles, grabs some merchandise, and runs off.
How could this happen? And no one stopped it.
It's just so horrible.
Who is this dastardly criminal?
I guess you would call that barking and entering. Of all the dumb criminals on World's Dumbest Criminals, of course the smartest criminal, a dog. She found the bone by sense of smell. I can read things, and I can't find what I want right away in a grocery store.
This is part of an entire crime spree that this dog has been committing for months. If you go inside her little doggy bed, you will find well laid out blueprints of pet stores and red barns across America. Oh.
Local news shows the surveillance footage that night. An area family recognized the criminal as their dog, Akira, who traveled nearly 12 miles round trip just to get the bone.
Drop me off 6 miles away from the nearest brothel. Then I'll find my way there and home, just for a moment.
Akira's owners return to the store to pay for the stolen goods and buy another rawhide bone, proving in this case that crime really does pay.
If the crime is this adorable, I don't think you can legally prosecute it.
That's a good dog, Akira.
Hi, Roger Lodge here with an important message for Americans with disabilities. Don't let anything keep you from following your dreams, even if those dreams involve criminal behavior. Take this Miami man, for instance. When it comes to robbing convenience stores, he refuses to use crutches as a crutch.
I got a pack of cigarettes. Yo, sick up, man. Yo, you think I'm playing? Give us some money, man. Come on, hurry up. You stay there, man. Don't try nothing funny. I pray I'll come right back here and take you out, too. See you later. Move out of my way, man. Make it a getaway.
Kudos to you, sir, for following your dream all the way to jail. And how can you not be inspired by this Broward County man? Three broken limbs can't keep him from breaking into a gas station storage room to steal smokes.
Yo, I got him. Yeah, there you go. Get on in there, man. You get me some cigarettes, too. Let's go. Hurry up. Get out of here quick before they come out. Let's go.
Police are still on the lookout for the wheelchair-bound bandit, a man who refuses to let his disability be a liability. And who could forget the guy who tries to rob an auto parts store, gets in a struggle with an employee, and leaves a little piece of himself behind? He manages to stay one step in front of the cops until they track him down using the serial number on his fake leg. That's rough. Take it from me. We live in the greatest country in the world.
A place where anyone can be a criminal.
I'm Roger Lodge. Thanks so much for being here.
A couple and their friend pull into a Phoenix, Arizona gas station. The woman stays in the car, and her boyfriend fills the tank, while their buddy buys some cigarettes. Returning to the car, the smoker decides to play a practical joke.
Hey, dude, check it out. Got a light? Hey, you guys pumping gas? Your friend, huh? Yeah? What's it?
You know that big picture of a cigarette with the X through it that's right on the gas pump? It's there for a reason.
I mean, hello. It's not the gas that ignites, it's the fumes that ignite. You're a dumbass.
I mean, even Tonya knows this.
I would like to see what his other ideas of jokes are. Hold the life support plug just for a second. Just for a second. Hey, look, I kicked a puppy. Look at me, I'm hilarious.
As flames engulf the car, the woman manages to escape.
Oh my God, the car's on fire.
And her boyfriend grabs a valuable from the back seat.
Get the baby.
Come here, sweetie,
get
come
the
in.
Baby, please.
Come here, baby, I got him.
Car's on fire, get me out, mama, please.
The family escapes from the fireball unscathed. But their jokester friend suffers burns on 20% of his body and spends a month in the hospital.
Who's laughing now? They're taking skin from his buddy's ass and putting it on his face to heal him.
A pair of teens break into a Minnesota laundromat.
I got it. Hang on.
How much cash do you think's in there? It's not like when you go to a laundromat, it costs $40. To do your pants.
You gotta go through the other way, man.
I think I feel a quarter.
Go the other way. What about under?
Okay, they're trying to break into a laundry machine for quarters, but what's probably 2 feet away? A quarter machine. Full of quarters.
What are we gonna do? Rob a bank? No. They'll trace that money. Where's the untraceable money? Quarters. You can't trace a quarter.
Yo, okay. Man, keep trying. There's a lot of quarters in there. Just think about what we can do with all the quarters, man.
The most they could have gotten was $15. And then what are you going to do with that? You have to split it halfway. Maybe that one guy can go buy a shirt. But after you got the shirt, where are you going to go wash it? Some dickhead just broke the laundromat.
Now there's no quarters.
The thieves eventually drop their money laundering scheme and leave without a cent.
This is why I don't do laundry, because I can't be around this type of negativity. I'll take the hit on my smell.
Yo, man, forget it.
You've watched 19 dumb criminals screw up their crimes and their lives.
Bye, bye.
Oh. I see nothing.
But the world's dumbest criminal is still out there. Find out who it is right after this. Two men enter a Phoenix jewelry store and try to sell a damaged watch.
The bed is broken. I'm sorry. I can't buy this watch from you boys.
The two men take their watch and leave. Only to return moments later.
Look, pal, I really think you should look again at this. Just take another look at this watch. It's a good watch. Take one more look at it.
I don't need a broken watch. Oh!
Take that, old man!
What are you doing?
It was like a Clint Eastwood movie. Go ahead, punk.
Make my day!
Well, that's what you get when you mess with a tough old man. Give him an eye full of mace, he'll fill you full of lead.
It's like the most dangerous game of Marco Polo ever. You know he's kind of blinded. Throw something to the other side of the store.
Marco!
Hi, I'm Daniel Baldwin, actor, stuntman, and director. And I'm telling you now, when you're robbing a store, don't hide behind the desk. Dive through the glass and run your ass off. Thank you.
I'll show you your gosh!
He pistol whips the crap out of one of them. This is when I stood up. I was actually applauding at my house.
Take that!
Sorry, hurt your ears a little bit? Huh? How's your eardrum feeling?
Get down to the ground. Stay on the ground. You sons of bitches!
Sir, back off.
Help finally arrives for the besieged burglars.
I don't think criminals have ever been so excited for the police to show up.
The men are arrested for assault and attempted robbery.
I don't know if they have a message board or a Facebook group that criminals get together on, but they should just talk about this store and how you don't mess with it.
Please help me. Please.
Oh, that's good.
I don't even still don't know exactly what the f- we're doing. I'm just going to be brilliant at it. That's what I do.
Got a nice little rack going there.
Where'd I go? Here I am.
What's that sound?
What did I tell you?
Oh my God, you spanked this baby and it makes a cooing sound like it enjoys it.
Sorry, I don't know why that was making me laugh. It's not even funny.
No, Chelsea's hilarious. I think she's really funny. But she lives out here now? She's moving out here? Chelsea, I'm gunning for you.
I cannot believe you just did. She's not working.